Well, we know there's been a lot of controversy surrounding sunscreen lately, so we figured no better person to help us through this and navigate it is Dr. Alexis Decker with Apex Skin. So, Dr. Decker, first of all, thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Oh, thank you for having me.
It's our pleasure. Can you kind of sift through all this controversy for us, and what does it really mean, what we're hearing out there that's been in the news lately?
Sure. So recently there have been some new concerns raised about toxic chemicals within sunscreen and specifically causing cancer. So the Journal of the American Medical Association published a study, and it basically showed that the six active ingredients in sunscreen were found to be absorbed in the blood. But this study was conducted using high frequency application and also high volume of sunscreen application. So basically it was not real life application or frequency, which kind of makes it harder to determine the actual impact on humans. So oxybenzone is a chemical found in sunscreen, and then this study it was found to be absorbed the most. In another study, it was using rats when they ingested this chemical. It was shown to be found in high concentrations in the blood and possibly causing uterine enlargement. But it's important to keep in mind that the oxybenzone that was ingested by rats in the study was a much, much higher amount than what humans are actually absorbing. So we really can't conclude any causality based on this study. And we're kind of unsure of the link between these chemicals and cancer, and really further studies are needed. However, the American Academy of Dermatology states that the benefits of sunscreen outweigh any associated risk.
Interesting. Well, that's good to know because I think people hear those things, it kind of startles them. Are there
Absolutely.
any, aside from that, are there any other reasons for concern about using sunscreen? I mean, I know that's clearly been prominent, but I don't know if there's anything else that like is, you know, as people just think about using it, or should there any be any other reason for concern?
There have been some concerns that vitamin D levels may be low when using sunscreen, and especially in places like Ohio where we're relatively sun deprived in the winter
Yeah.
months. But they have done studies that regular use of sunscreen will not decrease vitamin D production by the skin. And most of our vitamin D actually comes from diet and not physical sun exposure. And there also have been concerns with the impact of these chemicals on coral reefs. And there is, again, we kind of need further studies to determine if these chemicals cause any real damage to the coral reefs. But one way you can kind of avoid this entirely is just using non-chemical sunscreen, so the physical blockers like zinc oxide and titanium dioxide.
Okay, so that's what we should be looking for as ingredients that we want, correct?
Right.
As so what are ones that we should not want, or what should we avoid?
Well, again, you don't really necessarily need to avoid these chemicals at that time because we really need further studies, and the AAD still recommends sunscreen use. But if you want a strictly chemical-free sunscreen, I'd recommend titanium oxide or zinc oxide products.
Okay.
And these are physical blockers.
What about people with, you know, people have a range of different skin types. Should every single person be putting sunscreen on their body?
Yes, really every person, even darker complected individuals, should be using sunscreen. It's a myth that darker skinned individuals can't get sun damage and skin cancer. So everyone should be using sunscreen.
Okay, so then it becomes how much should we be putting on our bodies and how often?
Sure. So reapplication should be every 2 hours. And under ideal circumstances, you should be using about 8 ounces of sunscreen every time you apply, which is equivalent to a shot glass of sunscreen. So it's a lot more than what you would think.
I think it's a lot more than people tend to put on their bodies too. I think they think, oh, fine little layer and I'm good to go.
Right, exactly.
So reapplying, you said every 2 hours then.
Correct.
And then on top of that, I think a lot of people, they're wondering as far as their sunscreen goes, sometimes they have it saved, they'll have it because they don't go out in the sun often. It sits in their closet for maybe years. I see the expiration dates on the bottles. Do you have to follow those strictly?
Sunscreen does expire, so I would recommend following them relatively strictly. Now, if it's just a couple weeks, you're probably fine. But I would recommend kind of re-upping on your sunscreen every year. And, you know, it is important so you get the full benefit of applying and using sunscreen.
And then also make sure that we come and visit you and all the other doctors there at the 10 different Apex Skin locations because we have to make sure that our skin's safe. Check those moles, check for spots because I mean, you just never know. Something that may seem to us, like something simple could be something we really need looked at.
Yeah, absolutely. 1 in 5 Americans will go on to develop skin cancer. So it's important to get your at least yearly skin exams.
Keep that in mind. I make sure I do mine every single year. Thank you so much, Dr. Stecker, for joining us. I appreciate it.
Sure. Thank you for having me.
Apply the sunscreen, folks. Apply it. Thank you.